Hi, this is Joe Pesce, and welcome to Modern Country Guitar. In this series, we're going to be learning tips, tricks, and techniques that all modern country guitars are using today. So grab your guitar, and let's get started. Today, we're going to be learning about the claw technique, also known as the Clawhammer technique. Now, what is it? Well, if you're a rock guitarist, most likely you play guitar like this, holding a pick and playing down and up strokes, alternate picking. But in country guitar, we've developed a system called the claw hammer or the claw technique. And basically, if you think of it in terms of how a pianist plays, if a pianist played with one finger, it wouldn't be so productive. So pianists use all their fingers. And that's what a bluegrass and country pickers play. They use most of their fingers, at least. I don't always use my pinky. If I need to, I'll grab a chord with my pinky also to get higher voicings. But traditionally, what we'll do is we'll hold the pick like this, and we'll use our middle finger and our ring finger to play the upper voicings of the chords. So if I'm using an A chord, I'll play the A chord. Instead of playing the A chord like this, I can play the A chord like this. I'm going to play the bass note with my pick, and I'm going to play the upper voicings with these two fingers. So I'm going to be playing on the second fret, if you know an A chord already, and then I'm going to be playing my middle finger on the G string and my ring finger on the B string, and I'll pluck it. So you can either play it plucked like this, so it sounds like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, or I can alternate like this between the bass and the treble notes. Let's try it together. So we're gonna do just together like this. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. And separate it. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. So if you noticed, sometimes the bass note is muted. It's not open. Sometimes I'll mute it with the flesh of my palm. And it's just so the notes don't start ringing out and getting sloppy sounding. So later on, you can start doing more syncopation. All right, so let's get to a rhythm now. We don't need no stinking picks. We're gonna put the pick away and we're gonna use just our hand for this one. I'll play it for you first, and then I'll break it down. So this rhythm you might hear in a song by Mark Knopfler or Brent Mason, even on the bluesier side, like Bonnie Raitt. So it's a combination of country and blues together. Let me break it down for you. It's basically an A chord, a D over F sharp, or you can play it with your thumb like this. So it's a second fret on the E string, and then I'm playing second fret with my middle finger on the G string, and third fret on the second string, the B string. If it's more comfortable, you can grab it with your thumb on the bass note, and then to a G, which you probably should know how to play by now. Here's the rhythm broken down. So I'm starting with open strings on the fourth string and third string, the D and G. And I'm going to hammer on to the second fret on those strings with my pointer finger, just barred. So it goes Then, you see what I just did? I did a slap, almost like how bassists slap their guitars, their basses. So that slap is basically what the snare drum is playing for the rhythm. So a lot of times you hear snares playing on the two, beat two and beat four. So I'm slapping on beat two. Now, after I slap it, I'm gonna do a downstroke with my thumb on the A string, and I'm gonna mute it with my palm. So it's gonna sound like this. Try that. After I do that, I'm gonna pluck the second fret again on the D and G strings, fourth and third string. So it's gonna sound like this. So what we can do also is we can do like this. Make it even more, adding a little touch of blues into it. So how I do that is, starting again, open. After I do the downstroke on my thumb, I'm gonna be taking my pinky finger on the G string and second fret on the D string. What I'm gonna do, which makes it that blues magic, is bending the pinky slightly. So I call this an androgynous third. It's not a real musical term, but basically it doesn't know whether it's minor or major. It's somewhere in this world in between the two. So I'm bending into that world. So it sounds like this. So actually, when we're done, I'm pulling off to the second fret again. Okay, so all together we have so far. Next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do a downstroke and an upstroke with our thumb. Muted. So if it's not muted, it'll sound like this. We don't want that. We want it muted with our palm. And we're gonna hammer on, excuse me, open to hammer on to second fret again. So three, four. Okay. Now what we're doing is we're taking the same position that we had before and we're gonna move it up a whole step. So we're gonna be on the fourth fret of the D string and the seventh fret of the G string. So it sounds like this. I'll do it really slow. And slide back down. So we're actually sliding it. We're hitting the second fret, sliding up to the fourth fret, and sliding back down. So. Now this one, when we go back, we're on the upbeat. And then we go to the D over F sharp. So D over F sharp to G. I'll play all together now. Now, if you don't want to hit a G, because your bass is most likely to be playing a G also, I'll show you a cool lick you can do. So it'll sound like this. Let me break down that lick. So we're taking from the D over F sharp, and instead of going to the G, we're going to play this lick. And then we're gonna be moving our ring finger to the second fret on the G string. And we're going to play an open D string at the same time and quickly hammer down to the first fret on the D string and release. Now slowly it sounds strange, but when we play it fast, it actually sounds really good. And then the last thing, so. So we're taking our pinky now on the third fret A string, which is a C note, and we're bending that to that androgynous third like I talked about before, and then to an A. So. I'll play one more time for you guys. That's about it for this lesson. I hope you got something out of it, and I'll see you next time on a new Modern Country Guitar.